Hello, my name is Rick Johnston. I work at the World Health Organization, and along with my colleague Tom Slaymaker at UNICEF, I co-lead the Joint Monitoring Program for Water Supply, Sanitation, and Hygiene, or the JMP. The JMP was founded in 1990, and since then has tracked progress at the national, regional, and global level for water, sanitation, and hygiene targets. So this new 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development includes 17 Sustainable Development Goals. And these cover a range of topics from poverty to health to peace and justice, education, gender equality. And you can see there's also a dedicated goal on clean water and sanitation. And this is different from the Millennium Development Goals, where there was a target for water and sanitation, but not a full goal. Now, within Goal 6, there is a target, Target 6.2, on sanitation. And that target reads that by 2030, we should achieve access to adequate and equitable sanitation and hygiene for all, and end open defecation, paying special attention to the needs of women and girls and those in vulnerable situations. And the global indicator for this is the population using safely managed sanitation services, which is defined as the population using an improved sanitation facility, which is not shared, and so far that's the same as the MDG indicator, but with these new elements, so where excreta are safely disposed in situ or transported and treated off-site. Improved sanitation facilities, this information comes from household surveys, which ask people what's the main type of sanitation facility your family uses, and the improved responses are flush and poor flush toilets, whether they're connected to sewers or septic tanks or pits, different kinds of latrines that have slabs, composting toilets, new systems like container-based sanitation, whereas unimproved facilities have less engineering and protection, so pit latrines without slabs, hanging latrines, or bucket latrines. And then, of course, no facilities at all counts as open defecation. Now, from household surveys that collect this type of information, we plot the results separately in urban areas and rural areas. And you can see that any one data point is going to have a different value. And sometimes even two different surveys within the same year find slightly different results. And that's why we go with a linear regression among them to get the best fit from all the available data separately in urban and rural areas, and then combine those to get a national set of estimates for all years. These data then are used to populate the sanitation ladder, where people practicing open defecation or using unimproved sanitation are at the bottom. And then those who use improved facilities are in the top three rungs. If those facilities are shared between two or more households, it counts as a limited service, whereas ones that are not shared is at least basic. And if the excreta are safely disposed of in situ or transported and treated off-site, that counts as safely managed. So there are really three ways to get counted as safely managed. You can have wastewater treated off-site through sewer systems, or excreta from on-site systems like septic tanks or pit latrines that are emptied and treated off-site, or excreta that never goes off-site, it's treated and disposed of in situ. Shared sanitation is practiced globally by about 10% of the population, and sharing happens in both rural and urban areas. And shared sanitation can be really well managed. The excreta can be perfectly safely managed. It can also be poorly managed. But the main reason that shared sanitation doesn't count for basic or safely managed services is around the other human rights aspects of privacy and dignity and accessibility. So then, among these three pathways into safe management, let's first look at safely disposed in situ. Now, we have information from household surveys, new questions that are being introduced about pit emptying. So a question like, has your pit latrine or septic tank ever been emptied? The last time it was emptied, where were the contents emptied to? And from that, we can say that something's safely managed if either it's not removed at all, it stays in the ground, or if it's removed and buried on site. The second pathway into safely managed is waste from on-site sanitation systems, which are emptied and treated. So again, if we have information from households about emptying of septic tanks and pit latrines, households may well know if it's been emptied, but may well not know what happens to the waste once it leaves their property. So here we look to the sector for data about the sludging services, trucks that empty and transport wastes, to fecal sludge treatment plants, or sometimes to wastewater treatment plants that can receive fecal sludge. So combining the data from households about emptying with data from the sector on how those wastes are managed. And then the third element for safe management is wastewater treatment, and that's where households report having a sewer connection, and we rely on sector data about, well, how much of that sewage actually makes it to a treatment plant and is treated. Now, sectoral data is primarily covering urban areas and often contains information about the level of treatment by service provider. Often, treatment is categorized into primary, secondary, or tertiary treatment, depending on the type of processes that are used. And the JMP considers secondary or tertiary treatment to count for safely managed sanitation. Primary treatment is normally not counted for safely managed sanitation unless it can be shown that the effluent from the plant is discharged far away from human contact, such as with a long ocean outfall. So there is quite a lot of sectoral data on wastewater treatment plants, at least the type of technology that's used in the treatment plants, but there's very little data on how well contained the sewer lines are, and on the transport of wastewater to the treatment plant, how much waste is lost in transit through leaky pipes, or even from household connections where the pipe from the household never connects with the sewer network. It's very difficult to get data on these kinds of losses. So bringing together all those different types of data, in July 2017, the JMP published its first SDG report with baseline estimates for safely managed sanitation services, as well as the other rungs on the ladder. Let's take a look. So at a global level, we calculated that 39% of the population, or 2.9 billion people, used a safely managed sanitation service in 2015. And of course, that means that 4.4 billion people lacked safely managed sanitation. We were able to make estimates for 84 different countries and 5 out of 8 of the SDG regions. Also, if we look at the basic level of service, 5 billion people used at least a basic sanitation service. That means basic or safely managed. But 2.3 billion still lacked basic services. Then you have 8% or 600 million people using a limited service, requiring where facilities are shared, and 892 million people, 12% of the global population, still practicing open defecation with no sanitation facilities at all. In our 2017 report, for the first time, we disaggregated the different types of improved sanitation into those using sewer connections and those with on-site sanitation that's improved, so pit latrines, septic tanks, etc. And this shows some really interesting trends, that at the global level, the world is actually very evenly split, with 38% of the population having sewer connections and 38% having improved on-site sanitation. But if you look at the different regions or the different groups, you see some regions where on-site sanitation is highly prevalent and others, typically more high-income countries, where sewage is the dominant sanitation form. And of course, in those different settings, there would be different programmatic approaches to improving safely managed sanitation. Many countries now are looking at this global framework and adapting it to their own national contexts and setting national targets. It's not expected that every country in the world aims to achieve 100% safely managed sanitation services by 2030. That would be unrealistic for many countries, and many countries will struggle even to reach universal basic or even to eliminate open defecation. But the framework represented by the safely managed services and the ladder is very appropriate to countries at any stage of development. So there could well be national targets set around service coverage, how many people use improved facilities, how many people use improved facilities that aren't shared, how many people use sewer systems, even though for the SDG purposes, sewer systems or non-sewer systems can be safely managed. Among those who do have sewer connections, there can be targets about leakiness of networks, about the level of treatment, and the subsequent use of effluent or the handling of effluent that could be appropriate national targets. combined sewer overflows are one of the main ways that fecal wastes from wastewater treatment plants can be released into the environment, and there can be control measures put into place to minimize those. But septic tanks and latrines are often absent in these planning frameworks. It's certainly possible to register and monitor septic tanks or latrines, to set conditions about where latrines can be constructed, what types of areas, and to have more oversight about emptying services, whether it's registering or monitoring desludging trucks, or tracking how much of the sludge reaches a treatment plant, and when the sludge or the waste reaches treatment plants, what kind of treatment it receives, if it's actually treated to national standards. On the latrine side, there could be technological targets around certain types of latrines which are inherently safely managed, like twin pits or composting latrines. Or there could be other targets that enhance safe management, such as use of compost from treatment plants or recovery of heat and energy from wastewater treatment plants. So in conclusion, the new SDG framework and the focus on safely managed services represents a major shift from the MDG paradigm of use of improved facilities. Increasingly, attention will be placed on not just what kind of facilities do people use, but how is the waste from those facilities managed. If those people have sewer connections, how much of that waste really reaches a treatment plant and receives appropriate treatment before discharge? But maybe even the bigger data gap is around the 38% of the global population using improved on-site systems. What happens when those fill up? What happens when septic tanks are emptied? How are those wastes transported to treatment plants? What kind of treatment do they receive? These are new challenges, both for monitoring, but more importantly, for service delivery, and will have big impacts on sanitation programming in the years to come through the SDG period.